A seasonal killer, variability of the incidence of necrotizing fasciitis with the weather pattern. Authors are De Silva, T. P. U. P., Bandara, H. M. C., Ratnayaka, R. M. S. S. B., Karunadasa, M. S. E. Paper will be presented by Dr. De Silva, Senior Registrar in Surgery, Columbus South Teaching Hospital.
Good afternoon, Chairperson, Madam, Sir, and colleagues. I am Dr. Upul De Silva, Senior Registrar in Surgery, and I am going to present a case study we conducted at Base Hospital Mahiyangana, named Variability of the Incidence of Necrotizing Fasciitis with the Weather Pattern. So, as we all know, necrotizing fasciitis is a surgical emergency caused by mono or multibacterial infection. It's a fulminant infection involving skin, subcutaneous tissue, and deep fascia. And it causes significant mortality, about 21% according to NewGen 2020, and high morbidity rates, including multi-organ failure and amputation rates. The other problem is high cost to the healthcare due to prolonged antibiotics, prolonged hospital stay, as well as frequent wound edema. So there are well-recognized risk factors for this condition, including multiple comorbidities, reduced immunity, including diabetes mellitus, and trauma. However, the effects of environmental factors such as climatic changes on this condition has not been investigated in the literature adequately. So the available limited literature shows, mainly including Miller and Saho, they discuss about staphylococcal infection with the ambient temperature change and the humidity changes. So, but considering our rural society, such as Mahiyangane, where the community is based on agricultural background, so if we find association between weather pattern with this condition, we can make changes. We can make preventive changes to minimize this condition. So we conducted this descriptive study with the objective of determining an association between the incidence of necrotizing fasciitis with the weather pattern, mainly the rain pattern. So it was a retrospective analysis performed from January 2018 to March 2020. So we have included all the admissions with necrotizing fasciitis to our surgical unit, Base Hospital Mahiyangane. The diagnostic criteria were depending on ICD-10. And we have excluded necrotizing fasciitis following trauma and surgery. Then we compare this number of admissions with the necrotizing fasciitis with the average rain pattern to Badulla district. So we have a total of 231 patients were analyzed with the mean age of 55 years with male predominance. So we have obtained weather pattern for the Badulla district from weather on worldwide weather online, which is a web-based provider of global weather, and we have assessed the correlation with the number of admissions monthly. So as you can see in this linear graph, you will see the correlation, and we have assessed statistically the strength of correlation with the Pearson correlation coefficient, which showed about 0.676% of correlation. So in conclusion, we have identified a moderate to high correlation between this average rainfall and the number of necrotizing fasciitis admissions. And so our plan is to arrange studies to determine the causative factors to see the why this correlation is there. So we suggest the other investigators also to assess these sort of things, because prevention of this condition is far better than treating them because of the high mortality and the morbidity. Thank you.
Paper is open for discussion.
show a correlation?
Yes, sir. It was a unit observation that this people are mainly farmers and laborers. So we have noted male predominance with necrotizing fasciitis admitted during this rainy season. So we started this study.
Is there a postulated mechanism why this might happen?
So we think of their personal protective equipment. They are not using it properly for this farming activities. But we are going to conduct studies on this causative factor assessment.
So other than staff, what you said, but, is there any literature on this necrotizing fasciitis?
Generally, mainly for staphylococcus infections, but that is not in mainly for the temperature changes and the humidity, sir, and not on rainy pattern. And we have a lack of funding for microbiological assessment. For that also we are going to assess in the future.
They are mainly laborers and farmers. During the rainy season, they are involved in farming activities and they can get cut injuries. So most of the staph and strep comes from their own flora. I think the weather pattern contributes through that.
Okay, madam. Anyway, we have to show it statistically with the future studies.
So, did you have any other way of standardizing these patients, like their diabetes or whatever other factors?
There are compounding factors, but those are common for both non-rainy and rainy seasons. So, there are compounding factors, but the main factor we are considering here is the rain or the weather.
Dr. Shirani answered the question that I was going to ask with the local traumatic events can cause it.
Yes. Yeah, there were actually there most of them are farmers, but we didn't see much cut injuries and as a significant traumatic injury that caused necrotizing fasciitis. If it is a significant traumatic injury, we have excluded because that is a cause, a compounding factor for our study. So during farming, they may have minor trivial injuries, but we didn't consider those patients. But if the patient is having significant preceding injury, we have excluded them from the study because of the compounding nature.
Thank you.
Thank you.